Hello, good morning. Today I am going to discuss the torsional vibration of multi-rotor system. Here given multi-rotor system, that is rotor I1, rotor 1, rotor 2 and rotor 3 having inertia I1, I2, I3 connected with shaft 1 and 2 having torsional stiffness of that shaft is KT1 and KT2, and that angular displacement have given as θ1, θ2 and θ3. So in case of torsional vibration of multiple rotor system is mainly used in, like, in mechanical point of view, internal combustion engine, and there are so many things like different type of rock crusher or different type of mill. So here we should consider that moment of inertia I1, I2, I3 of the corresponding rotor mass and torsional stiffness corresponding to shaft is KT1 and KT2. So at any instant, like, displacement is given as this one is θ1, θ2 and θ3. So displacement at various rotor as equilibrium position when having torsional vibration. But in case of the twist of the respective side at any given instant of time, like suppose after starting, suppose maybe you should discuss the or calculate that at 2 seconds what are the twisting at shaft 1 or either shaft 2 or either rotor 2. So you should display written as in relative format, that is θ1 minus θ2 and θ2 minus θ3. So in this way we should write down the different. So after that you should written as like Newton's second law, we can write the governing differential equation of motion. So here first this one is the θ1, so this one is the twisting with omega, so this one is omega, but this shaft having torsional stiffness, so this is opposed to that force. So according to that one, in Newton's law for linear motion, that is here given as, sorry, F equal to ma, but here the force is replaced by in torsional vibration, that is torque equal to I into alpha. I is what? That is I is moment of inertia and alpha is angular acceleration. So you should write down completely, this one is the I1 θ1 double dot, and θ1 double dot is called the angular acceleration and I1 is the inertia of that system, equal to this one is the opposite when twisting is given clockwise. So restoring force, torsional restoring force is in opposite direction, so that this one is the minus KT into θ1 minus θ2. So in this way you should write down θ1 I1 into θ1 double dot plus KT1 into θ1 minus θ2 equal to 0 for similar shaft 2. So in this case shaft 2 you should provide that angular speed omega, that means θ2 twisting, so corresponding θ1 is also effect, rotor 1 is also effect, having as well as rotor 2 also effect. So in this way this one is θ2 is greater than θ3, that means θ2 is dominate over the θ3 as well as dominate over the θ1 with influencing that coefficient, that is the torsional stiffness KT1 and KT2, that having the shaft 1 and shaft 2. So in this way we should write that I2 θ2 double dot plus KT1, this one is the opposite direction, so in this side this one is plus θ2 minus θ1, and corresponding shaft 2 is θ2 minus θ3. But in case of last one, that is rotor 3, that is only affect the θ2, and here it is this one is the free end, so θ3 is directly or dominate over the θ2, and participating shaft, that is shaft number 2, according to that this one is the KT2. So I3 θ3 double dot plus KT2, that is torsional stiffness 2 into θ3 minus θ2. So in this way we should write down the differential equation or governing differential equation of the multiple rotor system for mass rotor 1, this one I1 theta 1 2 theta 1 double dot plus KT1 into theta 1 minus theta 2, and corresponding I2 is this one, and for I3 this. So we should assume that the solution of the above differential equation in similar manner. For 2 degree of freedom we should assume that x equal to a sin omega t, but in here the angular displacement, that means theta I equal to phi I. Phi is, I is what? Amplitude of the torsional vibration into sin omega t. So you require that theta 1 double dot. So theta double dot I equal to phi I into omega square sin. And these two values insert in above governing equation 1, 2, 3. So in this way we can write that 4, 5, 6. That is I here minus I phi 1 omega square sin omega t minus KT 1. So sin omega t is common out, and but sin omega t is not here, sin omega t not equal to 0, because according to time sin t equal to 1, then sin not 0. So that this one term is 0. Similarly to I2, you should insert that value as this one. Similarly equation this, then you should get that equation 4, 5, 6. So next step, you should summarize, like, or adding equation. Suppose this equation, equation 4, 5, 6, you have to add them so that KT1, phi 1 here positive, but KT1 here phi 1 is also positive. Positive. This one is the KT1, phi 1, and KT1, phi 1 here KT2. So in this way this is phi 2 positive, and there the KT2 is negative. So in this way this is cancel out, and here is this one is a phi 2 minus phi 1. So this is cancel out. So only getting term is summation of omega square into II into phi I equal to 0. For I equal to 1, 2, 3. Here the number of rotor is what? 3. But for n number of rotor, that is I to n. So corresponding for n degree of freedom, this one is the generalized given equation. So according to that one, we should calculate that the natural frequency of the multiple rotor system. Okay. Thank you.